According to Ghana's small cocoa farmers, there is no future in cocoa farming anymore. The price is set too low for them to even make a living. But now a public spat has intensified the battle between cocoa farmers and chocolate giants. Our next report tells you more.
Chocolates. They are a must for every festive season. But as the world enjoys these delicious treats, it has left a sour taste in the mouths of cocoa farmers. Ivory Coast and its neighbor Ghana produce over 50% of the world's cocoa. But farmers only get a meager amount of the profits. Suppliers of cocoa products continue to profit by cutting wages of the farmers.
Cocoa farming is not having a future because of the price and how they give out the price from the market side. It's not right for us. We don't like it. You can see that cocoa future is so very poor. It's so very poor. We don't like it. We want the government to just increase everything for us because we spend time and our energy mostly in the side of cocoa business. But after all, we get nothing.
Now, in an unprecedented move, the world's two biggest cocoa suppliers are taking on chocolate multinationals. The cocoa boards of the two West African countries have publicly accused US chocolate giants of sidestepping a deal designed to shore up income for poor farmers. At stake is a 2019 arrangement called the Living Income Differential. The LID is a payment that chocolate makers are supposed to make to the producers. This is in return of a certificate that the cocoa is sustainably sourced. This means that its production is free of environmental and human rights abuses. While this certificate is very important for brand image, chocolate makers continue to flout this rule. Analysts believe that the joint public attack is remarkable. Until now, the CCC and the Cocoa Board have been virtually invisible to the general public. Their allegations now shed light on a cocoa market that is notoriously opaque. To add to the pressure, cocoa farmers are going to stage protest marches in both nations. The world's chocolate market is estimated to be worth more than $100 billion. However, only 6% of it trickles down to the farmers who grow the raw product. Tensions between cocoa producers and the chocolate giants have created a pressure on markets. But at the same time, consumption remains at an all-time low because of the pandemic. Bureau Report, WION, World is One.
Co-presented by Skoda, simply clever.
WION, World is One is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news updates on the move.